What's up, everybody? You are tuning into Horizontal Refreshments, episode 5 of season 2, and we are live and we are ready to give it to you good, give it to you fast, give it to you hard, soft, and everything in between. Once again, if you do not know, I am Jamal P.
I am Donnie Don Akeem, whichever you prefer.
And I am Brit Brad, short and sweet, or Jessica Rabbit today.
Period, Jessica. Or K. Michelle.
Ariel. So me and my mom be working out, and when I jog ahead of her, she always say I have the K. Michelle booty.
Well, hopefully not the new one.
I'm assuming she always say it's so big, she's talking about the old one.
Oh, okay. Because, child, we would hate for you to have the flubbed up.
Right. And today we have another special guest today, Miss Ashley Baker, and you want to say hey to the people?
Hello, people.
Right, and hey, you definitely got to get right on the mic.
Got to get right up on it, huh? Yeah. That's what we about in here.
Speaking to the mic.
Yes. Love on it.
Deep throat the mic.
Definitely have a lot of stuff to get into, but I guess before we do that, how's everybody doing?
Nah. Nothing interesting is going on with me.
I'm great.
Happy Cinco de Mayo to all of my Mexican people.
Hispanic?
That may be watching. I didn't say Hispanic because it is a Mexican thing.
Holiday. Yeah.
Oh, so, okay. Well, I just want to make sure we're pulling.
Right, right.
But okay, it's a specific
part
Mexican
of the Latino and Hispanic community, my fellow Mexicans that are celebrating some type of independence, aren't they? No.
It is the victory over the French Empire, Battle of Puebla. For those who don't know, please educate. This is no shade. This is me just speaking general. Please educate yourself on the holidays that you celebrate. So of course, go out there and get drunk, whatever. But remember that it does mean something. You know, we would probably be offended if somebody was like, "Happy Black History Month," and then showed a picture of chicken.
Jesus.
Now that's just willful ignorance.
But it's willful
ignorance. That is not a mistake. Because do we know the history behind St. Patrick's Day as we celebrate that? Does anybody know?
To some degree, I kind of do.
I don't. I wear my "Kiss Me, I'm Irish" shirt, and I go out there and I drink beer and I get drunk and I celebrate St. Patrick's Day. I have no idea why I'm doing that. But in our defense, when it comes to white celebrations and things of that nature, I really don't care
about those. Those are not important.
Shout out to Mexicans, though.
You just like the excuse to drink.
Just anything to drink.
Right.
Anything
that part to drink. Too, but
any reason.
Pretty much.
Yes.
So I could give less of a fuck about the 4th of July because I still ain't independent.
Well, that's my sister's birthday.
Oh, well, yes, aside from that.
Yeah.
Period.
That's the only
reason
we
why
we
celebrate.
Hello? No.
I'm sure. Because neither do I.
Child, it's not a. This is the holiday, okay. And anybody you know has a
Brittany.
Birthday on that day
is the holiday.
Period. You are annoying.
I can't wait.
So thank you, Jamal, for that history on our fellow minorities.
That's what I do. That's what I do. Yeah, today is pretty nice. Well, it's been it has been too cold, too hot type of day, and I like it.
I'm mad that it's inside. May 5th and it's still not at least 60 degrees.
It will be this weekend, right?
Right.
Consistently.
Right.
I only went outside to jog, so I was hot anyway.
Yeah. Well, if that's why God is keeping them from us, continue to do so, Lord Jesus, we would ask that we have a summer with nothing over 60 degrees.
Ooh,
If niggas gonna be out here shooting and killing motherfuckers,
they that do way. That in the winter. Fuck that. Let us get our little heat wave for a second. We only gonna get a second.
Yeah, we only gonna have June and July.
We only need 30 degrees. We only need 30 degrees. Just 30.
Period. Do we introduce our guest?
I did. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
He had my back.
I meant to introduce her specifically because she is my sister.
Child, yes, her sister. Honorary to me because I've been knowing Ashley since she was fucking... Well, since I was
since
fucking, I'm sorry.
Since you was in first grade.
I remember going to your, I think it was, how much older than us? Are you 10 years older than us?
Shit,
eight,
I don't know.
Eight.
Damn, Brittany. I'm like four or five years older than 10. You.
I said four. He said eight.
I said ten.
Dang, four. I heard 10. I'm like,
he said 10 and 8. I said 4. Me and Taylor are 8 years apart.
The reason why I asked is because maybe I got the age wrong, but I remember being 8, I thought, and you having an 18th birthday party at Cool Waters.
No, that was my birthday party.
That was her birthday party. Okay,
but was she 18? Because she had just beat cancer.
No.
No,
she had just beat cancer.
Damn, my time,
baby,
my
your timeline. Time oh, see,
very
don't remember everything.
Hadn't even been diagnosed with
time. When I was a child,
she
I'm
had
sorry.
Just had my nephew, sure so did. She was like 16-ish. Yeah.
Well, if y'all was 8, I was 12. I ain't had no.
You
kid
was grown
at 12.
When I went to this one party, so it had to be like 4th grade. Then we had to be like.
Well,
10
I used
or 11.
To do it every year for like. 5-6 years in a row.
But you have
so.
To remember that I only was able to make certain ones because I was
I know,
always gone.
Out of town. Yeah.
So Cool Waters right where off the highway used to be, right?
Yeah,
I don't even remember where it is no more.
It's on the south side.
It's still
oh,
there.
Never mind.
It's
I was
still
thinking
there.
Other like water hotel resort where you.
Oh, drive. Country what? Springs.
Country
that's
Springs.
That's called something different now, too.
Yeah. Is it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's called something else.
I haven't been there in so long.
I haven't been to either in so long. I just remember that I couldn't swim and that you had to have this code to get in the water. And I used to use Patrick's code, Pepperoni Patrick, to swim because you had to have like a phrase to swim at
you
Cool
can't
Waters.
Swim?
Pepperoni Patrick?
Yeah.
I can't swim in water above my head. What you mean still? This was back then. So, yeah, I can't swim in anything above my head, child. Or I freak out.
So what is that, like
5'11"?
Over 5'11".
Yeah.
Hi.
Hola, ¿cómo estás, mi buen? We heard about your morning. We heard about your morning, Ladarius. Well, I did.
A horizontal refreshment morning. Yeah. So, thank you.
Is that what happened?
Yes. It was on Facebook. You didn't see the horizontal refreshment.
I haven't
darling.
Really been on Facebook today. I had.
It's funny because I hadn't either, but when I logged on, that's what came across. Right. Yeah.
Apparently, I need to go scroll or something. I've been on the phone all day.
I haven't been on Facebook like that, period, lately.
Yeah, you ain't been on Messenger either, apparently.
I haven't. I've been. Okay, well, I guess I need to check my Messenger.
Y'all gonna get pregnant.
A couple of things to respond to.
They gonna get pregnant. All that urchin'.
Oh, chap. What you don't like the cocktail? Well, the wine cocktail.
I don't know. It just it didn't do it. For, did you try it?
Yeah.
What do you think of it?
I don't know.
Maybe my mouth is just really sensitive right now.
I don't know. Gloria kind of she's straight.
That's because of them horizontal.
No way.
Horizontal right. Refreshments from this morning.
Horizontal refreshments, child.
Good morning.
He's
like,
let's go. Just burning my mouth and throat.
Said, what percentage is this?
Thank you, Corey, for Milwaukee's talking airs May 8th. I am a part of that. I did host that. So
what's that?
It airs May 8th on PBS.
At
midnight. I know. I think it's a week. Well, May 8th is Saturday.
Is
so
Saturday.
DVR it.
What is that?
He's not. Well, it's not a series yet. I hosted it. For his particular show, but he's trying to get more episodes. But you know, the semester's about to end, so we should look forward to that in the fall, I guess.
Yeah, and speaking of, I guess, semesters, I am in the process of applying to grad school.
All right now.
That's wonderful.
Can we play
the round of applause? Oh.
So.
Right.
Still working on those pieces. You know, school is annoying, as we all know, and expensive. And if I didn't, I don't even say I have to, but if I didn't see it as something that I want to do and would benefit me, I definitely wouldn't. But it's something that I think I'm going to do, and hopefully I can get as much paid for as possible.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Ricky. As Ricky, I should know how to say his last name by now. So we're former roommates and friends. So,
yeah. Well, congratulations on that decision. What are you trying to get?
I would do MPA to master's in public health, and potentially there's a program that has public health and social work together.
Period. So, yeah. I could see it, and that's that on that.
Yeah.
Hey,
so we got a lot of people watching today.
Yes, hello. Hey, Ricardo.
That was that flyer.
Well, speaking of it.
Just use. You said fish bait.
Mm-hmm. I saw that picture. Like, ooh, this refreshments. Is the one.
You look like you watch Housewives.
I look very inviting, don't I?
You look like you was in a dungeon, honey.
Okay. You look welcome better than dungeon. A few of them that was
definitely
in
was
dungeon.
In the dungeon.
Sure. Well, speaking of the dungeon, darling. Oh, if y'all had to pick a name for yourself in the dungeon, what would it? What would it be?
A-N-O-N?
What does that mean?
Anonymous.
Oh.
That's
ooh,
cute.
Anonymous.
Like
that.
That's cute.
Oh, you've been practicing. Speaking to the... She already got it ready.
Leave me alone. Got a couple of more subjects.
Oh, Lord.
I would probably find some kind of symbol or some shit. Right.
Well, mine known would probably as. Be lame like the Housewives was. You know, they was like peach juice and chocolate and...
What was Portia in there?
Peach juice. Peach juice. And I probably... Because I would give up on trying to be super creative. So I'd probably just be like...
I don't know.
I like the one that Candy came up with for Andy.
Andy, Silver
that
Bullet.
That was slick. That was cute. Now that one yes. was slick.
Mine would just be Mister.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Mister.
Right.
You gotta say it like that. Mister.
You hear that, Ladarius?
Ladarius, you hear that?
Ladarius.
I don't know. I don't want a copy of
him. Since
to
go shave, Mister.
Mister and Sir.
Real right. filthy.
Or did y'all see that Color Purple meme that I posted?
It was I posted like, it too.
Yeah, I think I took it from you. It was like Life Lord. After Mister. And it was like Oprah and being Oprah.
Oh.
I didn't see that.
Oh, people got too much time on their hands, honey. They had Oprah and Whoopi on this flyer looking like scruffles. But the bust down ones from like the Players Club, though.
Ooh, not the bust down
ones. Not the bust down
ones.
Yeah. Oh, Lord.
A mess. Ooh. A mess. A mess. Oh, I saw that.
The Color Purple is actually a cute name for a strip club. If you had a purple lights, yeah. The color purple
some
for a strip club,
lights,
yes.
Purple room.
Yes.
Hello.
That
period.
Used to shit me and my sister would name our strip club.
The color purple. Everybody, girl, I'm going down to the color purple. All
right.
See, Mister. Yeah, that would be a good name. Child. Anywho, so, what did you come up with a name?
I said I'm gonna have a symbol.
Hey,
they don't
girl.
Even know my name.
Oh, it's...
Like Prince, like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm just a movement.
Yeah.
Where's? Bring her to me.
Bring her here.
Bring her.
Bring her, yeah.
I need
Mr.
Crown.
Wona. He's tripping.
I don't know.
Y'all got me drinking this dirty water.
Yes, right.
And that's killing Jamal.
Right. He's retired.
Had my share. I need to heal my mouth, apparently.
I heal your mouth. Well, you got to do the death this morning, didn't you?
Well, did you get surprisingly, someone else was using their mouth.
Oh.
Well, not even surprisingly. That's pretty normal. But, you know, normally I would be doing that too. But I was serviced. And it was cool. You know, somebody was trying to send me off to Denver. Denver in a good way.
Just love.
Yes. It's nice to be sent off correctly, honey.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Always.
Mm.
So you don't think about nobody else while you're out there.
Right. I just jag off to the last situation that you had with your significant other.
How long are you gonna be gone for?
To Monday.
Too long. Always traveling.
Is it tomorrow's Thursday, right? Mm-hmm. Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday night.
Mm-hmm.
Four nights.
That's sure. A good like.
I'm being dramatic,
time.
Okay? Let me have my mom. Thank you.
Right. No, like me, I'd be like, go.
Yeah.
Go. Go.
Really? Jamal leave too much.
Yeah, well, I mean, if my partner traveled as much as Jamal, I would be like, why you always gone? But nah. I think it depends on the partner because I'll be like, okay, go.
Ladarius asked me right where the mask is on from what I see. That's
true.
Yes, this is true.
Like, oh,
nice.
He's going riding, at least like
he be riding mall piece trips. Suitcase like bitch where we going we here
hell no so we have a comment from Jamal here for just some Jamal wisdom. They say in a okay he finna open the door. All right, they say in a poly relationship you can't truly love two people at the same time. False or true? I guess we could start here.
I said he tired of the bullshit. Well, I came here for
no, with the small talk. For
poly.
Well,
amorous.
I love that we
why
start
are we
with
not
that.
On subject here?
Right. So I guess just to give a little people backstory, if you didn't know, we are talking about polyamory or polygamy. Right, what did I say? Polyamory?
No, that is one. That's basically like an open relationship. Yeah, they so have, it's different and definitions for each one. Yep.
And that's
different where, levels, definitely.
And
different
I
levels.
And I think that's what we're gonna get into. I know I'm not an expert, but I'm someone who knows a decent amount. I think we all have different levels of like understanding of it, so it should be a good conversation, I guess. You know, we could all probably answer that question, but I guess since he name dropped me first, I'll say something. Can you go back to it? I'm trying to remember it.
Show it, darling.
He said you can't truly love two people at the same time.
Well, I guess my quick response is false because everybody is different. Every relationship is different. There's plenty of videos, news stories, books, and stuff that you can read on people who are in different types of polygamous type of situations. Whether it is, you know, I specifically, I just watched the Red Table Talk on it, and it was really good. And it was, you know, Jada, it was Willow, it was their grandmother, and they had different people that were experiencing polygamy in different types of ways. And there was a woman, there was a guy on there who was married. They had been monogamous, and then eventually throughout the relationship they became open. And then all of them have like different partners. And then the guy basically, he has his wife who he loves, that's his main partner, but he has another main partner who he loves as well. But he lives with his wife, but then his wife is also cool with the other girl as well. So it's levels to it. It takes all types of, I think, to be in those situations, all types of mental strength, all types of security, all types of everything. But it isn't for everyone. And I just believe there's power in whatever you choose. And if it works for you, it works for you. So that's my spiel. Mm-hmm. If
anybody else. Well, it is actually levels to love. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have two sisters, you love them, right?
Right.
You can love two people at the same time, but it could be for different reasons, different levels. So I would say it's true. You can love two people at the same time, but it definitely won't be the same type of love. It could be a different type, but you still love them. Get me together, honey.
Makeup on the set.
Fix mother. Yeah. Fix mother.
I had to help out. So I agree that you can love two people at once. I don't think I've ever been in a situation of being in love with two people at once. There are certain people I will always have love for. There are certain exes that I'm never like, if they really truly needed me, Sorrell would probably be upset because I would help them. But as far as being in love with them, like want to be intimate, want to be a part of my everyday life, I don't know that to be true. But I don't think it's impossible. Just because I've never experienced it or don't feel it doesn't mean that someone else can't be in love with two people at the same time. I think it's quite possible.
I feel like the two people in the relationship are the two that define that relationship.
Corey, good night.
That was polygamous.
That was polygamous.
And it was okay.
They weren't that healthy.
The way he said it, though, child.
But it depends on the two people. Like, they define it. So, as long as the two people that are in that relationship are okay with that dynamic, I think it's perfectly fine. Could I personally do that?
Well, be in love with two people?
Yeah. You hell could. No, I would not want to, honestly, just because I put a lot of energy into that. into love, into my relationship. So I'm only trying to deal with just him. But for other people that it do work for, I'm like, hey.
That's the thing, too. Like, I Jamal, you know, as someone who is in the same community I'm in, I've been seeing a lot of things within, like, the gay community of people, like, downing it. Like, is this the new normal? Like, why does... And to me, it's, first of all, why does it matter if it doesn't involve you, for one? Right. For two, it's been a lot of accusations. And I don't know everybody's relationships, right? Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Maybe he is cheating on his mm-hmm. significant other. He's not being faithful. But you don't know the ins and outs of that relationship. Yeah. So just because he's in your inbox or talking to you, you're making the assumption. Because there are a lot of polygamous relationships in our community and in the public at large. Mm-hmm. People are not... Well, they're starting to be, but some people are not as open about it because of the stigma surrounding it.
Yeah, I was going to say there's a lot of stigma and there's a lot of stigma specifically. We'll get to that. There's a lot of stigma within, obviously, our own community as an LGBT community and specifically as a Black community, because a lot of, like many things, we don't have a lot of representation of things within our community. So there isn't as much representation around polygamy or polyamorous relationships in our Black community as there is, like, in really just white, light white communities. So that's usually what you see. And that is one of the things they talked about on the Red Table Talk episode, because they had a Black woman come on there who wrote a book on it. And, you know, she said the purpose of her writing that book is because there isn't that many, like, Black examples of that. And there's all types of other issues why we might have stigma and stuff like that. But I think it's also important, like, those comments and those statuses and me commenting on those things, and you comment as well. None of this stuff is new. It's been around for thousands of years, or as long as people have been around. It is just resurfaced in a different way, or becoming, I guess, reaccepted, because there was a period of time, hundreds or thousands of years ago, where it was. Obviously, modern religion came in and colonized many countries and many
colonialism,
all that, and that way of thinking.
You white motherfucker.
Us, you know, even being us being taken and brought here, our way of thinking before is totally gone. So we obviously think like
the pale face ones.
We think like the white pale face ones from 400 or 500 years ago that were enslaving us and they were putting Christian norms on us. So that's my spiel on that.
I wholeheartedly agree with that. I won't step on nobody's toes by going into Christianity. That's another episode for another day. Not only it's about sex. But I definitely wholeheartedly agree, and I do think that representation is important, because even with me growing up, I didn't think Black people could be gay. I thought something was wrong with me, because there was no mm-hmm. Black gay people that I saw. So just imagine how that can apply to the certain demographics that you fit into, not being, you know, you don't see them. So if somebody yearns or wants to be in a polyamorous relationship and they happen to be a person of color or Black and there's no representation of that, imagine how that may, you know, could...
Right. Or if everybody around you like, girl, that's late, or blah,
yeah,
blah, blah.
Like that. But like, I that's why I appreciate what you said. It's not for you per se, and I do think that there's a difference though, because I don't think being a polygamist is for me, child. Because I can't imagine coming home to 7 different niggas.
Also, it just sounds like too much work.
It ain't got to be 7.
It just sounds like two. Even if it was two. It sounds like too much damn work.
It is definitely a lot of work.
Both of them
want something. I'm more open to a one-off of a threesome with my significant other. I'm more open to...
Sound like double the
if you're going to New Orleans, or I'm going to Cali, and whatever happens there, we could keep it there. We don't have to discuss. I'm more open to that.
Yes.
Right.
Same.
I mean, I get
that. Same. Same. Threesome on vacation, goddammit, but I ain't trying to do this 365, though.
Yeah. Like, you motherfuckers.
That's too much energy.
It takes a lot of energy. It takes
Are you speaking from experience?
That was my question. Have you ever been in any type of relationship?
I'm single in my bedroom by myself. Like,
a whole lot of energy.
Hey,
sister.
Hey, Jamal. Yeah, I commend anyone who is open to polygamy, because I'm not one of them. I'm pretty territorial. I already know.
You didn't kill somebody.
Right. And that's one of the things they talked about, like jealousy and territory. Because the grandmother on, which Jada's mother, they talked about, she was like, jealousy, like, but that's something I guess a person has to get over or understand. Because I guess once you're to that point where you're not jealous or not having insecure or whatever, you wouldn't technically, I guess, care
but
about
you know it, what? Like. That's interesting because if you flip it to the dynamic like you kind of did before, like with my friends, I don't want Alex ain't got a best friend, other best friend. Like, what are you talking about?
No.
You're sis. That's why she said it. She said, hey, best friend. Hey, sis.
Oh, Lord.
Hey, Jamal.
So what if she developed, like,
I would be jealous. But the thing is, I would deal with it. I would deal with it. You know what I'm saying? I would get over it. So I kind of, I guess, if you take that logic and put it in a relationship.
Slowly.
Ew, why can't I deal with eventually over time? It is.
It's something you got to balance.
And I knew her friend. It takes a lot of communication. It takes a lot of communication, and you got to be a strong individual to be.
So, have you been in any type of whether it be open relationship or had some sort of you know polygamous relationship or thing like that, or some sort of boundaries you have
that you want to share?
Came to share. So first, I'm gonna start off by saying a lot of people have already been in polygamy relationships unknowingly.
Without even knowing, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Sure have.
I know, you know, you could be in your relationship with your guy, and he could have a whole nother situation going on.
Yeah.
And you don't even know. But I've been approached by about 5 different guys about being in polygamy. I fancy the ideal of it, but I don't want to be the add-on.
Yeah,
I don't want to walk into something that's already established.
I want to be the main one.
I want to be the one to choose our girlfriend.
Mm.
I don't want him to choose because in
their
your
choices
mind,
be garbage.
In your
let's just keep it 100. Their choices be garbage.
Some West Allen, like,
right? Trailer Park Trash.
Oh, man.
Talk to me now. But I mean, I'm just saying, like, it's just a whole like a control thing because. In my mind, if he bringing me her, I'm going to be like, oh, that's what you like? That's what you went and chose?
Yeah.
And he doing it for selfish reasons. It's for him and his pleasure. What about me and my pleasure?
Right.
What do we have in common?
Yeah.
You try. Okay, you,
I got to deal with her, too.
So you when you're saying, really when you're picking, work? Are you keeping both of y'all in mind?
Let's be honest. A nigga going to smash whatever the hell I bring home.
If Perry, you better say that.
Is this right?
If well, I don't know. To me, I'm a vain motherfucker.
Am I lying?
If Terrell went out and picked a fat, dirty, nasty, stanky pussy, I would be like,
Doug will probably prefer me to choose because one, bitches flock to me when we go out anyway. Like I've already had the potential to bring somebody home with us on numerous occasions, and then on top of that, I like curvy, thick ass bitches.
Oh, I'll be looking.
He like curvy, thick ass bitches. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. He gonna like whoever I bring home.
So do you worry about, like, if someone's too attractive, would y'all be like, oh, no, not her. She's...
Hell no, because I probably gonna
if he
want
bringing her, it's all that's gonna be in the mindset. If he bring her, mm-hmm. It's gonna automatically bring insecurities. And then that's where that attitude come from. And you mind. You know what I'm saying? But if you allow her to choose, she's more comfortable.
Yeah,
she's more comfortable.
You're not as worried about.
You're not as worried because you know, like.
No, I was talking about like when you're choosing, like when you're like, oh, I would go for her because she's fine, but she's too fine.
I never think nobody is too fine.
I would prefer her to be too fine. That's perfectly fine with me.
That's okay because I'm choosing her, so it's at my comfort level.
Exactly.
Yeah. So
I'm choosing it for my enjoyment as well as his because I know
more so
he's gonna be pleased.
So have any of the guys who have, you know, approached you about those situations, were any of them black?
They all were black.
Okay. Well, that's cool. I was hoping.
How old
they were
all
refreshing. Do I know all of their ages?
There was a guy who couldn't handle it too, though.
Like what age range? Watching? Like were they like?
Oh, they everybody. They all in their 30s. I think the oldest one is 38.
Didn't somebody get chesty about it too, though? Like he couldn't handle it.
Oh yeah, he couldn't handle it because the whole thing is if he can have a girlfriend, I want a boyfriend.
Period.
But I need another. At this point, I need another man. I don't always want to be with a female all the time. I need some more testosterone around this joint. You know what I mean?
I love it.
Like, nobody can agree to that. Yeah. Nobody can agree to that. So until then.
You know what else I find funny is when you talk about like open relationships with your guy, when you talk about threesomes, why they don't never mention another man?
Yeah, right.
Two men and a woman.
First of all, I don't want another man. I've made that very clear. So if he mentioned one, I would feel disrespected. Okay?
Her personally.
Me personally. I don't.
Because I just watched something on Basketball Wise with Jackie. I actually was watching this last night. And they had asked, because one of her weddings on Basketball Wise was dedicated to the LGBTQ community.
Yeah, I remember.
And they had asked her, like, do you think Doug is gay? And she's not the first person, woman I heard say this on TV. I don't know how genuine they're being, but she was like, I never asked him if he was gay. And honestly, if he was gay, I would still love him because I'm in love with him as a person. So, I appreciate that answer. I'm not sure I always believe that answer. But I appreciate the answer because I would love for him to be like, I'm gay, and her to still stick there. And we'll see. You put it to the test.
Because, yeah, I'm like, that's a bit of a stretch for me.
And I think in those situations, that's where they have that's where they would have to.
You already know.
Every relationship is different. Every situation is figuring out, because I've seen, you know, I've seen like news stories or whatever, documentaries where like a couple that was married, the man ended up transitioning to a woman later.
Oh, wow.
And they stayed together. Like, they might not, I don't know if they were so into, but like,
did
they loved each
other. Did he still have his hardware?
We could be friends.
I don't even know, but I know he transitioned.
Excuse me?
And they were still together.
Hopefully.
They were still together.
I hate no one.
Sounds like Pokemon. Gotta catch them all.
So every situation is different. So you might love somebody and realize, like, okay, they might have a sip. Like she said, she might still love him. They might not have sex, but like they might have kids, and like we can share this home. And this is what's important at this point in the marriage, is got these assets, we got this home, we'll stay together.
I struggle with that part, because just because I could still love some, like if somebody I was dating decided to transition, I love you and I respect you, but I am not attracted to titties and. Well,
they might have.
I was about to say,
but that's where the. But that's where the situation might be, because it's like they might have an agreement, like, well, we're not gonna have sex. We might have sex with other people, but I still want to be married. I still want to hold your hand or walk or travel with you and do all these things and still stay married. So I think this one is just like every situation, everything different, I guess, for a different person.
Yeah. Well, I can only speak for me. I'm not going with a transition.
I was about to say, I personally feel like I will go for a polygamous relationship before I go for my spouse transitioning on me like that. Like, bro, that's not how I married you, bro.
Yeah, I'm like, sorry. And you have to understand. I understand they had a struggle in being honest with themselves, but like a lot of times, like I just actually thought about this today, and it completely came to me from left field, and it's crazy that it kind of ties in. Like being gay. People think it's about them, like your coming out story and stuff like that. And a lot of times when your parents don't accept you, you think it's because of your sexuality. But it's sometimes because your mom or your dad is looking at it like you're already black, you're already this, and then you want to add this extra stigma on you. And it's not that I don't want you to be yourself. It's that I fear for your safety. I fear for you to be yourself in this world, because you're already targeted. Now you're making yourself a double target or a triple target with transgender. So saying that, I don't know if I could dip my foot into that, because that is a lot of stigmas, child. And not saying there's anything wrong with stigmas. If you want to live in your truth, then live in your truth. But
you
I just
be strong to live in your truth.
That's just not for me. And I'm just, I don't know. Child. Fix it, Jesus.
That picture of Jamal look like an author.
A Carl Weber book.
Yes.
the back of the book.
Or that show, your photo for JP Consulting.
Right. Contact me.
You need the Airbnb.
How do y'all feel about orgies in relationships?
Orgies in relationships.
You know.
Well, how do you feel about, first of all, how do you feel about orgies, period?
That's fine.
Because polygamy is not just about sex. And I think we'll touch on that later. But like,
polygamy is an orgy.
No, because.
Yes, it is.
In a way.
It's a life orgy.
All sleeping
it's a
life.
If you put it like in the theory of like, but it depends, because there are polygamists who are like,
I've seen where, like, this is my life partner who I live with. This is another person that I just like to play video games with, and we have that type of intimate relationship. This is a person I just like to go on dates with.
That's too much work.
And there's so many different levels.
That's what I was getting at.
That is way too much sexual. Work.
Like, because even in some polygamous relationships, they don't have sex together. Yeah. Like, the guy has sex with, because to me, the definition of an orgy is five or more. Because it's a threesome and a foursome, and then after the fifth person is added, then, bitch, you're in an orgy. So, I think that's the technical definition as well. Don't quote me, but you know I probably know.
You probably do know.
But you know I probably know.
But, like, even if you're in a polygamous relationship, doesn't mean that you're all having sex together. So, true. You could be a polygamist and not want to have an orgy.
True.
True.
Child. Yeah. So, like, what are y'all feelings on orgies?
I just don't want multiple penises in my face. Let me just. That's
so
why
just one penis.
When we go to, because I plan for us to go to a strip club in New Orleans for my birthday as well, it will be mixed because I don't want penises bouncing in my face. I'm all right. I'm cool. I'm good. Multiple women, I'd be okay.
So I'm saying, like, women, there's a preference for women in these type of
situations. For me, it is. I can't speak. Not all women are like that, and that's cool.
No, I think majority of women are like that.
I'm not saying nothing against them. It's just not for me.
I'm fine with two males, three females.
Some people is cool with that. I can't. Three females.
It don't matter. How just mix it up. What about transgenders? Like
transgenders.
Are you into? Pansexual. Yes. Are you?
Yes.
Oh, I love it.
My sister is freaky. She's very openly.
I like meeting women like that for whatever reason.
I'm free. Yeah.
I'm just attracted to people.
Like an open, delicate flower.
That, honestly, you know, I think... As okay as it is to know your identity, and there's also power people don't, because, like, I at one point identified as pansexual, and I don't necessarily rule that totally
too much
out.
Sounds like a lot of work and a lot of limbs.
Because sexuality is fluid. Yeah, and if you are, like, there's been people who have trans experience who I was attracted to and think, like, I could definitely have sex with them.
So would you consider yourself a pansexual if you're sexually attracted, or if you are just, like, for lack of a better term, visually attracted? So, like, because I found some trans women and some trans men, like, attractive, and I'm attracted to them, but I don't know if
so
I want
to. So, with the right amount of liquor, you probably would get physical with them.
Well,
so, yes.
With women, shit, that's definitely the case.
Yes. Yes.
The right amount of alcohol.
I've seen it.
Definitely get it cracking.
Definitely.
We felt boobs together in the bar.
So I've licked titties in the bar.
Not mine. Just to make sure that's clear.
I never went past a motorboat with you.
Oh, God.
And even, I was just going to touch really quick on the orgy question, too. I think, you know, sometimes the idea of group sex is cool. I have been in group sex situations, and I knew
you was going to give us a story.
And I found it a lot of times, I guess, to be too much, because a lot of times I end up being focused on one person, and then all the other shit is just distracting me. And then I'd be ready to go.
Oh, you're taking a distraction?
I agree, because somebody had asked me about threesomes that hadn't had one, and I was like, to me, they're a little overrated. Even a threesome, as simple as a threesome, because the most I've had was a four-way last summer, when I was telling y'all.
Oh, yeah.
But the most I've had was a foursome, but before that, I had my share of threesomes, I'd say at least like five or six, and they were all like too much. Like, I was more attracted to one person over the other. The other person was kind of like, can you go?
Who brought the third person?
It would depend. Sometimes it would be me, sometimes it would be...
In that situation where you was over it.
All the situations I was over it. Because you know, I'm a top and I will be attracted to a top. He's attracted to me, but we need a bottom. So we need to find a bottom. I find the bottom, but I don't want them there because... And you and I are attracted to each other, so why are they here?
All of that.
Like, they provide an asshole, but, like, whatever. I'm not really attracted to them like that. So, and it would happen vice versa. Or if somebody else was attracted to me, they didn't want to do whatever, and then they would find somebody.
Right. Like, it would have to be, like, a really, really super, like, natural type of situation. Even then, it still might. But like, at least with that, maybe nothing's planned. But like, if we're planning, like, yeah, we're gonna go to this orgy, I would be pretty hesitant. Like, yeah, I probably don't want to go. But
so, do you in that situation where y'all just need a bottom, you know, just for an asshole? Do you tell them that
no, they just the like asshole? You are just an asshole? No, it's like, do you want to have a threesome with me and my guy?
Right.
And then you send a picture of your friend.
It
and
still just seems so mean a little bit.
So mean?
Yeah.
Girl, I ain't the nicest person.
Well, I'm happy you admit it.
It's not really that mean to me. It's just kind of like, this is what it is. This is
girl,
what we needed.
So, Ashley, have you been in a group sexual situations before?
Oh, yes.
Can you tell us about that?
How recent?
That, when you said it was a distraction, that kind of like threw me off a little bit because it's exciting. You know, you get all the sounds. It's like real sounds. It's like 4D. It's like watching porn in 4D. But then you can like, you ever been watching a movie and be like, damn, I wish I could get in the screen and be in that movie? Mm-hmm. You can actually do that. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was pretty cool.
So, you could be in a groove of doing something to one person, and then somebody just come and feel like they want to do their little stuff to you, and you don't feel like nothing. I'd be like, I was into this. Get your ass.
I got the flow exactly right.
Yeah. It's all about the vibe. It's all about the vibe.
I don't know who y'all.
But you'll use a glory hole, though, right?
I have not.
Oh, you have not.
I have not.
I have.
Ball head. The innocent one.
Never. We have bonded.
But I can't say that I would never. I just haven't. I don't even know where to go. And I don't want to go.
Oh, you don't want to go. Because if you wanted to go, you would find out.
Better. Hi, Terrell. I just make Douglas put his dick through a hole or something. And just
you should do that. You should do that. You should do that.
When you come home from work.
One day.
Yes.
One day. Be like, insert here. Ooh, I'm going to make it for her.
Make it for her.
That's a great idea.
That is a great idea. I'm going to have to take advantage of that.
Yeah.
But you got a doorway
you don't want, I guess. To cut
your dick. We might need something to hold us the hell up.
Y'all done already broke sinks and shit now.
Oh, god damn. Yes.
Counters. Our bed. We just got a new one. We fell off the bed y'all a couple weeks ago.
Y'all just need to put
ago.
Y'all bed on some crates and just quit playing.
We got a platform bed. Mine don't move.
Platform bed.
It wouldn't help us from falling off that motherfucker like we did a couple weeks ago.
On the floor, oh, Lord,
I'm finna say.
We did after we fell.
We said, we got to keep this thing going.
Exactly.
Little carpet burning here.
We got a kid. We got to keep getting it in.
I don't know what part of the conversation.
It was Doug's fault we
he
failed.
He was giving the side eyes to, or the looking eyes to.
Probably he want the sheet. Off the bed.
He want the glory hole.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not mad at you, Doug.
That's cute. Yeah. Because people do that. I mean, there are people, you know, who are like on apps and stuff. It'd be like, you know, have a glory hole set up. You come over. It's usually like a sheet.
Yeah, but see, I've always been worried that the person on the other side of the sheet was white.
So, most of the time, I guess they are. At least here.
I see white people.
And I just always.
There was a black guy who I guess who knew about something
was
that was
he
here.
Because that's my other fear.
I don't know. I think I've seen it on
you
like,
are
Twitter
so
before.
Super.
I'm dead.
He's dead.
I'm serious. I can't do over three.
So what if you didn't know and then
I probably throw up. Like no, I'm so serious.
And then they
I probably throw up. And you know I'm not being dramatic by choice. Like I be dramatic, like it'd be like real life, like I'm not acting. Like The other day when they said that somebody at the job had bed bugs, you should have seen my reaction. Like, everybody knew something was wrong. Because I was like, oh my God! Like, what the, why would they? Yeah, they like, honey, it's other patients. I'm like, what the? I cannot. So, yes, I would probably throw up if I saw a white motherfucker. Or they didn't have no teeth or anything like that.
You just don't need to see the motherfucker behind
Johnny Glory Hole racist. Right.
The Glory Hole say no white, no whites. Sure.
No white. I'm talking fans. About sheets with holes in them. So look, it already sound racist. You
right?
True. Jesus, it sounds so like a we already
started off on the wrong foot.
Right. It's a white man behind a sheet mic with a hole in it.
Shout
pity
out.
With a hole in it. Pity with a hole in it.
There you go.
I'm going over to the sheet with holes in it.
Right.
That is a white sheet too. You said look for the white sheet.
Right, the white sheet with the hole in it. What? Don't let it be pointy.
There you go. How many holes?
Or the sheet. Or the sheet falls and it falls on them. Oh. And it makes
but you know what? They may need that dinner with his motherfucking ass.
Swear.
He got too many damn requirements. They gotta have teeth and all kind of shit. You came for the penis. Right. You ain't gotta kiss me.
That's teeth, why I thought I said before on the show, the I'm pleasure. Too vain to do that because I, first of all, I like to see the face of whoever's giving me head. But if I don't, then I like to know who's behind it. Because if it's somebody.
You ain't ever care about the face of some of them.
Well, they was. They was cute
I
to
know.
Me.
Right. So everyone sucks your dick has been
attracted to me. To me. Oh, the shade and the read and the reach and the things that you think I don't catch. Oh, my detector, honey. Jamal is funny. So.
Y'all is.
You would think we was all high as much as we are laughing.
I think she's talking about right. Only attractive to me.
Oh, yeah. That's for you. And that's for you. You know that's for you.
Polygamy. Oh Lord! Yes. So let's get back.
Oh, we off topic like a motherfucker.
So what if y'all?
Everybody like, what's the topic? What are y'all talking about?
How would the conversation go with for you, or how would you have this conversation if your partner did bring it to you and like, I want to explore this a little bit more?
Well, I've already done it.
You were in polygamy.
No, but I've expressed that because I think that it's something that I may be open to one day. And it definitely depends. I'm not leaning one way or the other, but I've already expressed, like, if we're 5-10 years in and, well, not even, like, 3 years in, I do feel like you need to lay that foundation before you just jump out the window. Mm-hmm. For me, personally.
Definitely has to be a foundation laid.
If we were, I'm like, I'm not opposed to it. We don't have to do it, especially depending on how I feel in the relationship at that time.
Ooh, this
but
I
am open to it.
Yeah, and you can stop. And things people think, like, you can stop being polygamous when you want to.
Yeah.
You can do whatever you want.
So. Okay. Was we doing off that?
Yeah, go ahead.
Sorry. We have somebody who have a comment. I'm going to ask them right now, honey. Hold on 1 second. So it says, how do you explain it to the kids? Because she was just talking about it with her daddy.
Ooh.
That's why I happened.
Well, you explain it to the kids how you explain anything else. That's life. I think that the children, we need to stop thinking that children aren't people. They're little people.
They are definitely little people, and they do
they
understand.
Retain information.
Hey,
actually, talking
honey.
To the children will actually help them be more open-minded as adults and help them understand that everybody is not
different.
One way. You know?
So the way that I would explain it to my children, I explain it to my children. I'm going to tell you all this story. So a long time ago, I was with my kid's father, and me and my son, we were watching something, I don't remember, like Selena Gomez or something, because he was like in love with her.
Jesus.
I asked him, I said, oh, that's your only girlfriend? Or how many girlfriends you want? And he told me he's going to have 5 girlfriends like his daddy.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, you think that's okay to have 5 girlfriends? And he told me, he said, yeah. He said, I could have 5 friends that's girls. Oh. So that's how you can explain it to kids. You have multiple friends. You can say you have these are multiple people. Now, what they gonna call them, that's a different story. Is they all gonna live together? It's just like levels to it. Are you gonna bring this person into your home? Are y'all all gonna live with each other? Are y'all gonna merge the kids? Definitely like, it's just levels of comfort. Like, does this person have a kid? Do they not have a kid? They could be Miss Sherry, or this is Mr. Charles. He come over sometime from time to time. So it definitely depends on what your situation is. If y'all all gonna like be in different separate households, and then like you go over there, y'all go over there, and there's no kids, then there's nothing to explain.
Mm-hmm. Mm. That was a good breakdown to me. All that.
Yes. But I do think, in addition to that, because I agree, but I think we don't give kids enough credit for being smarter.
Kids
than
are
we think
smart.
They are.
Man. Kids
they
are
way
smart.
Smarter than
and
they
we
think they are.
And they're way smarter now because they have access to the internet. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I thought every generation gets smarter.
They get my smarter baby already and playing smarter Candy Crush.
Smarter.
Yeah, and kids are smart, and kids are open, and kids are non-judgmental. You know, the things that they learn are obviously from, you know, surroundings.
Bella looked like she judged everybody, though.
But I think that's just kids, my baby face. Yeah,
when kids are judgmental, it's from an outside influence. Because kids aren't racist. Kids aren't homophobic. Kids aren't anything. They learn all of those things. They don't care before. All they want to do is play.
Like oh, you make me smile. I want to be with you. Exactly. Ooh, I have fun with you. I want to have fun with you. And I mean, in a sense, that's kind of like what Polly is.
Right.
Like, oh, I like you. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you might take a sexual, sometimes you might not. It just depends. Like, certain people can feed certain things. And it's like, ooh, this person services me very well. But they sex trash. Mm. This person's sex is real good. But they can't service me. Right.
But they ain't nothing else but that.
You know what I'm saying? Or it could just be anything. Yeah. Somebody is filling in the void of something.
Yeah. Like, even if it's just like your hobbies, like this person, like I like to,
my head ain't big but nothing.
I don't know, like you like to play football or basketball, and this person, y'all attracted to each other, and y'all could do that together, and it really means something to both of y'all. You know what I'm saying? And y'all have that bond over that. Whereas this person, you feel like, you know, really like loves you, and y'all have that bond of intimacy and sex. And then this person, you know, get your fashion, and you know, it's like, I mean, I feel like that's the same thing with friendships too, because it's like, I don't talk to every friend the same.
Sure.
And
don't.
I don't tell every friend the same things.
Or all your friends don't enjoy the same thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Do those different things.
Like, if it's Housewives, I'm you, Alex, you know what I'm saying? But if it's
you know, it's kind of, I can't talk about some things now because I have been watching like old clips. Like NeNe clips and Phaser clips.
Yes.
And I
can
talk
about
it.
I finally saw you send me that on Snapchat. I was cracking up.
I got enough drama in my life.
Yeah, but like,
to the girls, we
we sleeping in your friend's room, bitch.
You better watch those B-words.
I'll pluck your eyebrows out and choke you at the same time. Bloop, bloop.
I don't have answers. I just know what I know.
But yeah, you have different friends for different reasons, so you can have different partners for different reasons. I'm just not sure because, maybe because I'm a man, maybe the ladies can speak on this or whatever. I'm not sure if... Yeah, I did. I'm not like whole garment right there. You would think we all smoke. Why is we so goofy today?
Give me
I'm not as sure how I will feel about my partner doing all of this stuff, though. So it's kind of like a little bias.
That's real.
Like, okay, we have an open relationship. I could do what I want to do. But that's why I'm like, I will keep it as, it's a don't ask, don't tell. Don't tell me shit that you're doing.
Yes, because I would have to constantly want to.
So that's the polyamory.
Very competitive.
That's, to me, that's more of an open relationship. Like, if you go out of town. If you go out of town and you fuck somebody, don't tell me that.
So is it just out of town? Can it be in town too, though?
You better not fuck one of my friends.
He better not fuck out of town.
No friends.
Me.
Wait, hold on. So you open to the point where it could be your friend? And there's no judgment. I'm just like, it could be your friend.
It's a question.
I mean,
definitely can't do the friends.
Hell no.
It's way. It's so many other
Johnny,
pussies.
Oh my,
I've had friends. I've had friends ask me to have threesomes with them and their boyfriend.
That's not the same. They asked.
So.
That's not the same. What I'm asking you is, if you were in an open relationship where you said that they could have sex outside of the relationship as long as they didn't tell you, but you found out that it was one of your Judy's.
How would I find out? How would I know?
If she got mad, slip of the tongue.
Oh, she got mad? He messy. We don't do that.
I love it. I live for it. I live for your answer, but child, that's not mine.
Yeah.
My answer is both y'all get
it. If I gotta tell you, then it's not really open. If I gotta tell you what you can and can't do, then it's not really an open relationship. Because I don't want you to tell me what I can and can't do.
See, that's why that shit ain't for us.
But that's why I can't do it.
The more we talk about it, the more this shit ain't for me.
Because if you doing it, I'm doing it.
No, but my thing is,
because if you doing it, I'm doing it.
Let me say this. I think it could be on different people on different degrees. Because your definition of it is, if I gotta worry about telling you, then it's not open. My thing is,
do what you can handle.
Exactly. Yeah. It could still be open.
So if you fuck my friend, I'm fucking your best friend.
See? Nobody
fuck your daddy.
You're
gonna be my
not even a friend. But see, that's how I would be though.
But
like if I found out you fucked my best friend, bitch, I fuck your sister. Just to prove a point, I ain't even straight.
Listen,
I will fuck your sister.
I told a bitch I will fuck her nigga and send her the video. She kept fucking with me. So petty Betty, I will get
but
the job done.
I just don't want to know. So if I was ever to be in that, I wouldn't want to know.
That's the satanic Bible.
Well, I have my qualms about the Bible, so I'm gonna shut up about what's in that mup.
I was gonna answer that question initially earlier too, of like, and how the conversation would be with a significant other. I'm kind of like you the same way too, like where I necessarily will never rule, I guess, anything out. It's just we was laughing about that the other day. Didn't like the,
where's
your scooter?
Where's your scooter?
We was laughing in the mall. Where's your scooter? Where is it? I wouldn't rule anything out. I'm not necessarily looking to do any of those things now. But I have, because Darius likes to play dumbass jokes or take things to, like, he don't do it as much anymore because I tell him like you're doing too much. But he like joked about that one day. He wanted to like have an open relationship, whatever. And I knew he was joking, but I played along and I was just like, at the end of the day, I love you. So if we need to figure something out to, you know, make the relationship work, whatever, we'll figure it out together.
What was his definition of open?
I don't know what the fuck he said. He said something about he wanna, you know, he wanted to, you know, he wanted to see other people. I could see other people, things like that.
Because I was.
Yeah, he wanted to like sleep with other people. I sleep with other people, stuff like that. But yeah, so that's how he presented it. Of course, he was joking, but like I said, I will, you know, talk through and figure whatever out with the person that I love. It's all like, I guess, technical, maybe some stipulations, but everything is worth a conversation, in my opinion.
It's worth a conversation. So what happens if you have the conversation and the person says, I can't do this. It's not what I signed up for. Do you let it go or do you? You say, I'm at a point now where I'm being honest with you. I want to explore options. I want to start to maybe have someone else in the bedroom. Let's start there. And they say, that's not what I signed up for. I don't want to do that.
I think it'll probably be, it'll be easier for myself, or I guess I'll speak for y'all, for maybe us in here, because I think we are more open-minded, kind of have the same kind of thought of like, it's worth a conversation. We could see how things might happen, but I know that's not everybody's case. So I guess to answer your question, I wouldn't be responding that way. I don't think.
No, I'm saying, what if you? No, I wouldn't respond that way.
No, I was somebody.
So, how long is the foundation? Either. Like, how long have you been in this relationship?
Like, let's say it's been like 3 years, and you said
it's been 3 years, and my partner approached me like, "Hey, I was wondering." But see, I'm too open and spirited, so I'll probably be like, you know, I was kind of thinking the same damn thing about.
Like, look, I've been waiting for you to say something,
I was just going with the flow, but I'm glad that we're here. But I guess it. You'll say, you know what? As a matter of fact, I got a list.
What do you think of it?
Definitely was. No, I mean, but it, I guess it just depends on your comfortability.
Is that
what are you? What are you willing to
do? You lead a relationship at that point? If you're,
I mean, if you truly can't be your, if this is something that you truly want and you feel like you're going to be happy, if you're not going to be happy in that relationship, then you should end the relationship, because at that point you're holding yourself back and you're holding the other person back.
Period.
Because in the back of that person's mind, they're always going to be like, damn,
I can't do that.
Like, damn, it's Wednesday. They got podcasting. It's supposed to be over at 8 o'clock. It's 8:20. They ain't text me. They ain't. Yeah. Now it's gonna cause a strain, because now they're gonna be at you all the time. Like, where you at? What you doing? Where you at? What you doing? Where you at? What you doing? Where you going? What you doing? What you doing? Where you at? Where you at? Where you at?
And that ain't nothing more annoying than a nerd.
And that, you know what I'm saying? So now, because now their insecurities are at play now. So there's really no point in continuing that type of relationship if y'all truly can't make each other happy. What's the question, honey?
Yeah.
So, speak on it.
Where is your scooter?
Where is your scooter? Where is it? Well, speaking of the time, can we do a part two?
Can we do a who?
A part two? What do we think we got it? Oh, that would be cute. A couple.
I think it's definitely could be a part two.
Bring them out.
Jamal says, "Do you know? You know somebody?"
Yes, because she's getting the question, think about me. But no, while she gets the question, shit, I forgot what I was gonna say.
Sorry.
So, honey, are you? Do you want to be in a poly relationship and your baby daddy don't want to?
Before the store closed and stuff and whatnot, so that's why I'm.
She definitely asked me if I was taking applications.
Pew! Oh, somebody said they want to give it a try.
My sister got the juice for as long as I can remember.
The Kirby juice?
You got the juice.
Better
than the Kirby.
Better
than the Kirby juice?
Yes, baby. Better than the Kirby juice.
Ooh, Kirby?
I used to watch niggas fall over this.
Kirby? No, I think Kirby, it might be equal, because Kirby wasn't always attractive.
So what's his reasons that he don't want to check?
That's why I'm saying it might be equal, because since Kirby's juice was always there, even when she got.
Who's this? Who's Kirby?
Our best friend.
So if you.
I call her sister. She wasn't always.
Y'all
a
gotta have great. What's the actual question?
She does have the same last name as myself, so we really like.
Okay, I understand.
And I just want to be clear that Kirby was always attractive to me.
I got the question.
I thought Kirby was gorgeous.
It's just other people used to say that.
Kirby is definitely fine. Did y'all see that?
Child, she got the new picture she took. Child. Yeah, it's fine ass.
Oh, because he cheated before, and he think he's gonna be jealous. Right.
So we about to get our last question. All
right, got the question. So. A friend of mine's and her baby daddy want to try polygamy, but he says she is too crazy because he's cheated before and she reacted. But that's different. But that's different.
That's a fine line, though.
No, it's cheating. So you did it without permission and with ill intent.
Right.
Correct. But in this moment, you are together.
We are together as one, as a unit.
He
want to do it, or she want to do it?
She wants to do it.
They both want to do it, but he's like, nah, because she's too crazy. But this is definitely different. Y'all would have to have great communication. Y'all would have to choose the female together, or he would have to trust you to choose the female. It would have to definitely be on your comfort level. It'd have to be on her comfort level, because she's already thinking about he cheated.
Right.
So,
but he has a point, because she reacted. And as women, most of the times when they react, it's an emotional response, right? And it's an emotional response, meaning that it could be a trigger. So he's not, I don't want to call her crazy. Mm-mm. I'll call her emotional. Mm-hmm. So he's not wrong in thinking that if we have somebody else in the bedroom.
Y'all been together 10 years.
Cheating for 2 years. Niggas ain't shit. But.
Don't come by to me, y'all.
He ain't wrong for thinking that if they do something that she would have an emotional response, because to her, even though it's different and they're agreeing to do it, who's to say what would trigger her?
Yeah, I agree to some extent. There's bits and pieces of it that I can understand. So I understand his concern about it, but at the same time, she has in some way, I guess, or how is she crazy because she reacted to him?
It's a difference. He's looking at them becoming a polygamy relationship, yeah, and him cheating. Yeah. So
but I was just even thinking like his response to it.
That's what I'm saying. It's about an understanding.
But they still have to understand her emotions from him cheating, because I don't think you could just go from somebody cheating on you to being in a polygamous relationship and not have an emotional response to it.
That's they've been I'm together saying, 10 years. They have to have that conversation, though. That's what I'm saying. Like, yeah, they have the conversation. They have to set those boundaries and those levels and see how they go.
And they have
do
to
it.
Be honest, because people be lying about what they're okay. Like, be honest. You have to be honest about your emotions and know who you are as a person and what you can and can't handle. Because if you're doing it to stop him from cheating or to appease him or to alleviate some other type
it's
of stress,
about what's the
it's
reasons,
not going to work.
And that's what I asked her. What are the reasons that you want to do polygamy? Are you just tired of him?
That part, but the reasons for a man cheating never have to do with the person that they're dating. So let's start there. Very rarely. Very rarely.
If it happened towards the middle, she was not the same person she was in the beginning that got him.
He probably wasn't either.
I'm about to say he wasn't either.
Well, you said what was your percentage on that?
That's an excuse that men use to cheat.
Yeah.
You ask me, because to me. To me, I don't think it's much a person could do, because even if she tried to be the same person, let's say she was the same person, men still gonna do what they want to do.
I don't think cheating is about the other person, it's about the person that's doing it.
And that's period.
A person will cheat.
You right. You know what? Women do cheat too. Yes, they do. Let us not keep putting it on the men.
I don't date women, so
We do cheat, but there's still levels to that. Y'all just be cheating because she got a fatter ass or some shit. We be cheating because his pockets is deeper than yours.
I don't know.
But anywho.
I don't know. Because the child, now women do be cheating just because
women do
they
be
over it too. But most of the time, from what I've seen in my personal experience, women cheat because their man is not there. He doesn't listen. They found somebody else who listens to them. And usually
and
women need to be careful because those men are preying on them too. Be crazy, because they can recognize that, you know, you don't got a nigga that listen to you, so I'm gonna listen to you because I know that he not, so I'm gonna get what I want in the long run by sitting here listening.
Right.
These niggas be
tell him that I know like, that he creeping with that hoe. That's why I'm fucking the nigga that I be calling my bro.
It's from the
all day I dream about
song,
sex
iPhone the baby and Nicki Minaj.
Should have wore Adidas. I got on my Nike. Just do it.
I look like I
am I a cheater? No, I'm not a cheater because I'm not in a relationship.
All dicks is dead as snakes. That's
all dicks is what?
Dead as snakes.
I thought you were gonna say that.
I don't know. This shit had me goofy today. I don't know why. Well, shit, I'm already sitting there.
We didn't take his face. This, y'all have to figure that out.
We're going to do a part two for this.
We
got to bring some more. I want to bring some opposition.
Y'all have that conversation with us and then tune in to the next show.
Or she can be a guest. Shit.
Yeah, because we got three.
Ooh, they can come on here if they want to.
If you know any couples and people who are watching or people you know with personal experience who would like to be on here, definitely connect with us. We'd love to have them on.
Y'all know.
Okay, so next week, get them in line. And send us some pictures for the flyer, honey.
Yes, but
we're going to put them on and promote the shit.
Yes.
And make sure they're not homophobic.
But I think as we come to an end of this episode, this is definitely, I'll say on the air, been one of my favorite episodes.
Your favorite episode before we shot it.
I think we just talked about some really good stuff. And I can't wait to be brief about it. And thank you, Ashley, for coming on. It sounds like we're going to have you on for next week as well.
I can have you next week and the week after.
And the week anytime we want. Yes, but we definitely thank y'all for tuning in. Once again, I'm Jamal P.
I am Don Donnie Akeem, whichever you prefer.
Jessica Rabbit.
Period.
Yes. And you have just been tuning in to the wettest podcast around. See you later. Where is your scooter?